After an eventful and enlightening first half session, I, Umang Soni,
and I, Akshay Divedi,
welcome you all back to enjoy the BITM Business Convention 2016.
Our minds are rejuvenated and are raring to learn and understand more from the corporate stalwarts.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our next speaker, Mr. Shreyash Munot, Director Sales, Doehler India Private Limited.
I would like to call upon Dr. Dimple Saini, Director, Corporate Relations, to welcome Mr. Shreyash Munot with a bouquet of flowers.
Thank you, ma'am. May we now call upon Mr. Mangesh Nakade, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, to introduce Mr. Shreyash Munot.
A very good afternoon. Sorry, Akash. Sorry, the comparers. This is just impromptu. So, audience, how are we? We're very well. Yeah, I have great pleasure in standing here today to welcome Shreyas. He's a Balaji Society alumni. Can we have a huge round of applause? Come on. I feel so delighted when Shreyas comes in as a speaker. He's the director of sales of an MNC which participated last year also. He's been instrumental and he's a very passionate alumni. His details, of course, his introduction, I'm sure he will read out. But then Shreyas, it's a very great moment for all of us here, right? And I'm sure, you know, he's been, with the company for many years now, visiting, like he was talking to me, he was telling me, ma'am, our people are good. I said, are you really sure? He says, yes, ma'am, but yeah, they lack as good as any other B school because they are taking from the topmost B schools in the country, like probably an MDI, a Symbiosis, an FMS. So I said, you really tell me? He says, no, ma'am, we have our little drawbacks. Then I also warned him. I said, this is the post-lunch session. Okay, I said, Shreyas, post-lunch session. He says, ma'am, my college, my juniors. So Shreyas, thank you so much. It's great having you amongst us. And audience, my dear seniors and juniors, this is a lifetime opportunity for you. Can I have, again, a huge round of applause for Shreyas?
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, Uma. A very good afternoon to one and all present over here. It is my privilege to introduce our guest speaker for this session, Mr. Shreyash Munot, sir. Mr. Shreyash Munot, sir, joined Doehler India Private Limited as Accounts Manager in September 2007 and was elevated to the position of Director Sales in January 2013. Shreyash Munot, sir, started his professional career as Assistant Manager Marketing with Atul India Limited in January 2006. Shreyash Munot, sir, is an alumni of Indian Institute of Modern Management, IIMM, and Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Marathwada University. Sir, now I request you to please enlighten us with the words of wisdom. The stage is all yours. Thank you.
Hello. Yeah, it's okay. Hi, yaar. Good afternoon. In fact, if you ask me, I'm almost overwhelmed and embarrassed, feeling awkward as well. And it's like mixed emotions, to be very honest with all of you. Not used to getting a round of applause, believe me. I've been sitting over there several years back doing the same thing. And I've been telling Dimple ma'am and professor, director is the same thing. You know, I just find it very, very embarrassing. I remember the amount of pain it used to go to. Abhi clap karo, the clap is not nice, let's get it perfected. And apologies. You know, I was never part of any of the teams, unfortunately. I used to sit in one of the last rows all the while. don't clap. I think the professors are sitting over there. They'll mind what I'm saying now. So I've been told some things not to speak, some things to speak, but I'll still speak my mind, what I believe is correct. And it's been one hell of a journey from there on. You know, it doesn't matter whether you sit over there or here. It all matters what you have it here and what you speak eventually, what you do. And you know, it's honestly a very mixed emotion. The senior batch, the junior batch, I wouldn't call you students, believe me. You're all young adults, raring to go, going to pick up things. So it doesn't matter. You know what? This is the first time for me to address an audience as big. I've been doing sales meeting, but we are like 40-member team, 50-member team. I would do it for the entire organization, 100 members. So bear with me. If I falter, yeah, let's do it together. So yeah, brief introduction, what they read out. Yeah, I mean, I've been working for almost 10, 11 years, been with this company since close to 9 years now. It's going to be 10 years for me early next year. Brief couple of line introduction. Doehler, we are a German multinational company, privately held, family managed. We are one of the world's largest in what we do. The line of business, what we run in, if you were to go to any food and beverage manufacturing company, we are one of their core partners. We bring innovation, we are a supply chain partner, we are a manufacturing company. And I was there last year, presented, we decided to come in late. We are running a program now, which we started off last year. I've been rather instrumental in that, something called as a leadership program, let's say a mid-management leadership program. And it's a fast track program. We are picking up young talent. And what we want to do is in next 2 years, 3 years, we want to put them in managerial roles where they could lead, let's say, teams or functions is what we are doing. We decided late, we started building it up. So I was here last time presenting. The room was not as full as this because we were pretty late. But nonetheless, I look forward to coming down in next few months again, doing that again. That's it. So I leave the company introduction over there. I joined this company as a junior account manager almost in September 2007 sometime. And in 6 years' time, I started heading the entire business for South Asia as a sales director, heading sales and marketing. I'm involved in strategy. So, you know, today I can look back and I can give you very nice jargons and words and you should do this and that. Honestly, I don't think it's any way complicated. And over next 30-40 minutes, I know it's a post-lunch session. I know you have been sitting for 1.5 days. You still have to wear another 1.5 days. There would be speakers who would keep coming, talking about various things. So I tried putting something very different. I'm not going to go into a melodramatic, long, let's say, jargoism, jingoism based speech. What I've decided to break it up into three parts and talk to you about my experiences. What I see standing here when I was there and what I could have done different and what I believe is required today is what I would share with you. And you know what? Please feel free to, stop and talk in between. So I would say all the team, I don't know what is the team called now, please don't stop anyone from asking questions anywhere in between. There's no problem with it. Feel free, you can start off with questions. I'm okay with that also. The presentation is one part, it's just few slides which is there. That's one. And you know what, I would only tell you one thing. Yes, I am successful today. I would not deny that. I would not be arrogant, but I would be humble and proud to say, yes, I'm successful. It's come it with its own, let's say, time, effort, pain, cost, everything. But you know what, there is no easy path. If many of you were to believe there's an easy shortcut path, as many of the people would have spoken, there's no easy path. But you know what, I have a different opinion. There is an easy path. There is a simple and an easy path, which is all about keeping it very, very simple. Keeping it very, very simple is what I believe in. So I would take you through what I have in few slides. And yeah, let's talk through, let's have an interactive session. I hope no one falls asleep. because if no one falls asleep by the end of 45 minutes, I would rather take it as a compliment back that I hope I couldn't be so great to bore anyone to death. So that's what it was all about. So you still have 1.5 days to go more, or today's the last day? So best of luck. Have some sleeping pills. Learn the art to sleep with open eyes, which I guess most of you would have perfected till now. Which we all did when we were sitting in the last benches. By the way, I was there in those nice benches of Agrasen campus, which were meant to seat 12-year-old kids and 10-year-old kids, and we had the turmoil and pain of sitting on those. And you know what? They didn't allow us to sleep at all. The benches were so uncomfortable, they would ensure that we can't sleep. So yeah, guys, girls, managers, you know, honestly, the topic is a very, very, I would just speak very directly, and apologies to all the directors and everyone. It's a very fudgy, dodgy topic, honestly, if you were to ask me. And you know what, 15, 20 people coming and talking on the same topic, I think it becomes very, very, let's say, boring beyond a point. And yeah, so I'm glad we speak. Yeah, don't worry. You can speak your minds out. But you know what? I see both sides. I see your side very well because I've been there. But to run a large gathering like that, you cannot really have every other topic given. Maybe that could be something in future which could be done. It could be broken up into slots where different topics are there. The topic is very open-ended, so I have taken the liberty to interpret it the way I believe it is correct, and I have just put through a few things. So kicking it off, I've broken the session into three parts. The first one being very important is, you know what is the successful corporate career? I mean, how would you define it? And I would just want to ask people, students, managers, whatever you want yourself to be addressed with, what would you call it? I mean, could I have some opinions? What in your opinion is a great successful career? I mean, I'm sure you have spent, 1.5 years? The seniors would have spent 1.5 years in the campus by now? Yeah, and the juniors would have spent, 1 year, 6 months? Life is still great then. You still have a long way to go. Yeah, how would you define it as a successful corporate career? Yeah, just can you help with mics? Can they just speak? Just say your name first. Are you from the senior batch, junior batch, and what is the thing?
Sir, I'm Amir Azmi. I'm from HRD Marketing.
Hi.
Sir, so work is when we enjoy our work. This is it, sir. When we enjoy our work.
Absolutely.
For me, that would be success only.
I would not deny that. I mean, there has to be. You know, Amir, but Amir, right? Yeah, you know, you got it absolutely correct, but it sounds to me a little textbook type answer also. Sorry, I'm being very direct, but you know what? Why I say textbook type answer? Because everybody says I want to have fun. Who says I don't want to have fun? You know, anyone who says, have you found a beggar saying that? I mean, sorry, beggar would be a wrong example. Have you found a salesperson saying that I don't want to have fun? Have you found, let's say, a director saying I don't want to have fun? Have you found a maid saying that I don't want to have fun? How do you quantify that fun? How do you quantify that fun would be important. Anybody, I mean, think through it. I'm not pushing you for an answer, but just think through it. Anyone else want to give it a shot at trying to help me how to define it? I just need help because I've tried putting questions which came to my mind, and I thought I'll put it, that's why I put the word interaction, not one-way traffic which is there. Yeah, please. Yeah, hi Sumit.
Senior bank, Shadi. Sir, I think it comprises three things: respect, money, and position.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you guys are very mature here, I would say. Great answers. Honestly, believe me, when I look at you, and I must say that, I mean, every passing year, every passing batch looks to be much more mature than the previous one. I would tell you, at least me and the gang of friends which I had, we were not clear on this at all. Had someone would have asked me what is a successful career, corporate career, I would have said placement ho jaye, 20-25,000 mil jaye, usse zyada kuch nahi chahiye. That would have been my answer at that point of time, because I would speak to you later that how I ended up with Balaji is again a different story, which is a very funny one, which is there. But yeah, you're absolutely correct. Anyone else? Yeah, please. Yeah, but what would be those dreams? How would you define? So material dreams, right? Okay, no problem. Yeah, so considering the paucity of time and apologies for being late, I ended up into a long discussion with several people at college. And I would just leave with few, let's say, thoughts and some questions to you. I would not help you defining it. Because you know what, I can't do it for you. I would not give you a speech, what is a successful corporate career? Because had you asked me few years back, my answer would have been very different. I didn't know an answer also, I'll be very honest. I've just tried figuring out some answer for myself in last couple of years, and it's just come to me. If you ask me, if someone were to ask me, Shreyas, and I had this, I was just telling someone, I was traveling for last 16 days. I just came back to Pune, midnight, landed, got up at 11 o'clock, at 1 o'clock. I've not spent too much of time preparing this. I've just prepared in the flight last night. Just thought through it. And I was with our global head of sales. He heads the entire globe, and he and I were discussing. I was having my review day before, almost 11 o'clock at night. There was a long meeting which was going on. And he asked me, Shreyas, you're doing well. What is the next? I said, I've not thought through it. He says, why don't you, do you consider yourself being MD of Doehler India? So I report into the MD. He's my boss, and he's the regional director. So he was asking me, would you want to grow one level up to being an MD? And I straight away refused it. I didn't even take 5 minutes to think. I refused it. Now, how many of you think I'm stupid to do that? Please raise up your hands. Yeah, I mean, you guys are absolutely right. And I like the courage of the people who raised up the hand. I mean, I am sure 80% of the people who sit over here believe I'm stupid. You know what? Yes, from one perspective, it could be what I was stupid. But it has struck me in last few years, I don't want to be an MD. I don't want to be that. I enjoy what I'm doing today. I'm leading the entire team. So we have three business verticals. I lead three heads. They report into me. They have their teams. What I'm doing today is I'm building business in a strategic manner. New business groups, adding teams, building teams, empowering people, something which I've kept as a vision for myself in next 1.5-2 years. We want to build teams, self-sufficient teams. We want to build people who are solid leaders, each one of them capable of taking it to the next level of the organization. If I become the MD, I lose doing that on a daily basis. I get bloody petty affairs of somebody coming and saying, listen, the IT has a problem, this bloody operations has a problem. I don't want to do it. I've decided that. I want to continue doing this for next 3-4 years, and same thing happened. By the way, 80% of you who say I'm stupid, my head of sales also felt that, and he actually said, Shreyas, are you being stupid? On my face. So he says, well, you could think like that, and I explained him my logic. This is what I want to do. And if you would have asked me 5 years back, I would have said, yeah, I want to be the MD. I would have, not even 5 years back, even a couple of years back, somebody would have asked me, I would have certainly said, yes, I want to be an MD. But that's what I would say. Coming back to the point which I'm trying to, let's say, talk about, try to define what is a successful corporate career for yourself. And each one of you need to define it for yourself. I think something which is missing these days, and I see, I have my family, my nephew has just got placed. He was studying in another college, I would not name it. And I was asking him the same question. You know, Bhaiya, I want to be a CEO in next 5 years' time. I said, great. How do you plan to do that? Blank. No answer. No answer. Then I asked him, why do you want to be a CEO? And someone just said, material dreams here. Someone just spoke, yeah. So, you know, he exactly spoke, I want to buy my own Mercedes. I said, yeah, great. But why do you want to do that? So he didn't have an answer, and then it struck me, which I didn't tell him, and I would rather share with all of you seated over here. Is it like seniors are upstairs, juniors are downstairs? Is that like this, or? It's mixed, okay, I'm glad. So I don't have any section sleeping then. It struck to me that he and his friends, and I think large part of his friends, they all wanted, it was glamorous. I don't know, it was the college defining it or the alumni defining it. Who was defining it? You should be a CEO in 5 years' time. You should be a CEO. You should be a CEO. I mean, honestly, what the hell? I mean, and believe me, if I were to tell you or anyone is telling you that all of you would be CEOs, someone is bullshitting with you. Believe me. Believe me. I mean, I don't want to give you any crap over here. That is nonsense. All of you cannot be CEOs. Never. Not because you don't have talent. Not because you don't deserve it. But do you actually want to be a CEO? Do you actually want to be a CEO and would you enjoy that? Is that your passion? And that is what I would lead on to the other points. I've just related all those. What is the career you choose? I'll give you this nice story. Someone just told me several weeks back. I'll name the company for you. This was in PNG, and I know someone very senior up. They were having their, let's say, annual reviews. And one salesperson who is heading a country, his review was happening. And for last 3 years, you know, in FMCG, sales is a big pressure, right? Everybody knows that, right? Bechoge to job hai, nahi to everything is done and dusted, right? You can go and, I mean, feel free. Yeah, I mean, guys, if you're really feeling sleepy, anyone, I understand it's a turmoil, it's a pain. You can raise your hand, go out, wash your face, drink water. I have no problems with it. I'll ensure you don't get any whacking for that also. Just relax. So there's no compulsion to sit or anything. Just feel easy, yeah? You want to drink some water? Yeah, just pick up. You know, so their reviews were happening and this guy's sales were not doing well for last 3 years. And he was being whacked left, right and center by his bosses. Why is it not happening? And this gentleman who was his boss happens to be a close friend of mine. And then he told me that during the review, he was asking him some very direct questions. Why is that this is happening? So the guy, after immense pressure, finally broke down and said, I don't enjoy selling. Yeah, you know what? He said, I don't enjoy selling. And that guy was heading an area. So it means he would have been in PNG selling for at least if not less than 5 years. So you know, 5 years of his life, he was doing something he has never enjoyed doing it. And that is not even his flair. And that he's admitting after 3 years where he's been, yeah, sure. Well, yes and no. You're absolutely right. I mean, there is a pull. But you know, PNG, even if you look at India today, is PNG doing better or Unilever doing better? So there you have an answer. Not necessarily if you are in PNG or even for that matter, I'll change the example, make it Unilever if it makes it better to you. It's not necessarily that it has to be Unilever, PNG. It could be the topmost company. You take Google for that matter. It's not about the company, it's not about, what I'm trying to explain to you is a live example where the guy was doing something which he was not enjoying for 5 years. So yes, he was selling it, that's why he survived for 5 years, otherwise he would have been kicked out year one, year two. They would have not admitted him, so he would have got a big kick on his backside and he would have been out by now. So then this person switched off his review because their reviews are almost, they record the review. And they have a written review also, both which ways. So your discussion is also recorded. They have a live recording of that. In India, they're not doing it. Globally, they're doing it. So that's what I've got to know. So then he switched off everything. And he said, listen, let's talk heart to heart. So then he asked him, what do you enjoy doing it? My friend asked the gentleman, what do you enjoy doing it? He says, I think I can buy. I'm a good buyer. And you won't believe it what happened after that. Can anyone guess what happened after that? Yeah. So my friend, who was his boss, sacked him. Now you would all say like, what is great in that? You know, but that would be one of the sackings, which was done in one of the most transparent and a friendly manner. So what was agreed between them? They gave him almost type of a VRS or something of that sort. He was given 6 months of salary and he was asked to leave next day. And this friend of mine who was his boss advised him, listen, why don't you find a job where you can be a buyer, you can be a purchasing manager. And he actually got a job after 3 months in a different organization, not PNG for sure, a much smaller organization. And you know what? I just met that friend of mine last month when he told me this story. The gentleman who was sacked is head of a Danish multinational company for the purchasing team. He's heading a team of almost 200 individuals across the globe buying for some of the fantastic, he's doing some of the fantastic deals. So, and I don't think, I don't recollect his age, but he's somewhere around 40 odd years of age, 40, 43, something of that sort, I really don't remember. So, you know what? I mean, it's like Bowman Irani, just to take it even further. Yeah, everybody knows Bowman Irani's story, right? You all would know it. You know, but Bowman Irani's story is popular because he's well known, but it happens to all of us. So that's what I would say. What do you want to do is you would have to decide for yourself. And I know it's very easy for me to come and stand over here, give this nice gyan after 10 years being away from college, define success. Most of us, and when I was sitting over there, as I told you, it's not that easy to define it. It's not that easy. Believe me, I think only 15-20% of the people in this room know what is that they actually want to know. Or maybe the number could be higher now. In my batch, I thought only 10-15% people knew what they wanted to do. What is that they actually wanted to do? Where is that they actually wanted to be? What was the passion? Because you've all gone into sales, marketing, HRD. Yahi karna tha kya aapko? I mean, let's be honest, some of you would have taken admission into marketing just because that was available or that sounded jazzy, right? Yeah, so guys, but you don't need to do that mistake forever in life, you know? There's nothing wrong in it. It's not a mistake. You have done something which is right at that point of time. You know, we all take decisions in life at that point of time with the options which we have and the information which we have. So, you know, there's no point in regretting what we have done. You know, that was right then. You have done something which is right. But what do you want to do now? Decide. And believe me, there is nothing wrong in not knowing it today also. You may not know it today. You may not have answer today. Go with your gut. Do what you believe is right. But please keep thinking over. Please keep thinking over what is that you want to do. Maybe not today. Maybe 6 months down the line. Maybe after a year, you'll be able to pick up where you want to be. And the day you've picked up where you want to be, please start acting towards it. Don't wait for, let's say, another 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, because then you will do something which you would not enjoy. And I personally believe if you don't enjoy, you never give in your 100%. You never give in your 100%. I mean, there are theories, but yeah, personally, I don't believe in it. So I would say, think over it. That would be something which I want to drive home. You want to be a leader or you want to be a follower? Like, I gave you my personal example. I don't want to be an MD. I'm okay with having a different boss. I'm totally fine with it. So you need to decide, you want to be a leader, you want to be a follower, you want to be an analytical person. When I was here for the interviews last, I don't know, when did I come in now? When were we here? Yeah, last year, November. You know, we picked 3 people from the campus. So I've been to MDI, I've been to MIT, and I've picked up students from here as well. We picked up 3 students and they're doing fantastically well for us. I would rate them like really what we wanted out of them. We've picked one person who's doing an analytical job. He's on the pricing side. We've picked 2 people on the key account management side. We call it sales marketing, key account management. It's a different way we approach it. And I think the boys and the girls whom we picked up, they actually knew what they wanted and what they're good at it. You know, very seldom I've seen people at that age knowing what they want. And I think the reason why they're successful, they've actually nailed it what they want. The guy, his name is Javed. He would be your senior. He's into a pricing function with us. You know, he's doing one of the most complex pricings of products coming across the globe. And he's doing it perfect. Believe me. It takes while for someone to really get a hang of it. He's done it in 6, 7, 8 months. Another senior of yours by name of Yash Shah, he is handling Southern India territory for us. He is talking to the likes of, I don't know if you know food and beverage industry. You know Himalaya as a company? Himalaya? Yeah, so Himalaya is a very important account for us. He was just in a meeting with Himalaya's top brass just 10 days back. And you know what? He, along with his manager, obviously he has a reporting manager. He did the presentation and he presented for the deal. I don't know, yeah, it makes me really happy. I mean, then I guess you should all be proud that your seniors are doing very well. So that's what I'm saying. I think these boys and girls, they knew what they wanted to do and they're doing phenomenally well. I'm sure they'll do well in life. And we will ensure they do well in life because that's a commitment which we have as an organization, I personally. So I would only leave it on that. I know it's a very vague subject, but please decide what you want to do, where you want to be. Do you want to go to a sales role? Do you want to go to a marketing role? Do you want to be a buyer? Just because you have done MBA in marketing doesn't mean you need to be selling only. Doesn't mean that you need to be only into marketing. Yeah. I mean, you want to do digital marketing, you want to be doing, let's say, analytical things only in marketing because things are changing. There are very specialized fields available. Yeah? And pick up what you really enjoy. That's what I will leave it at. Any questions anyone has before I move on to the next section? Yeah, good. I'm saved. My ignorance is not exposed then. Yeah, this is a topic which is very close to my heart, and also, and I would talk to you not like one of the someone from industry who's come in and someone from let's say a corporate this thing. I would want to talk to you on this topic more like an elder brother, your alumni, couple of batches senior to you, and just take it from me on this topic and hear me out patiently. I know half of you would smirk it and say, listen, isko kya pata hai, ye to 10 saal ho gaye kar rahe hai, humko pata hai. I know how it happens. I've sat through all these. So, and it's fun to think like that at that time, point of time. But you know, the biggest problem which I believe today is, our education system has kind of got the word manager itself wrong. And anybody can help me? Why do I say that? Any thoughts? Yeah, it's a shell-shocking thing which I say. Because you know what? When you go out, and it is not your mistake. I don't think it is not at all your mistake. The way we are thinking, our social, let's say, environment, our structure. The moment we are placed, mera beta to manager ban gaya hai. Ab to ye achhi company mein manager hai, right? I mean, when you go into a company, yeah, welcome a junior account manager. But I think that is where the mistake is. I would personally request, emphasize, and tell you this, just don't get the word manager to your head. The moment you are placed, imagine you are joining an organization at the lowest rung of hierarchy. Even if you are five levels above, the people who are there could be, let's say, executives and everything. Just imagine you're joining at the junior most hierarchy. And take it as a request from my side. Just don't take it to your head that you're a manager. Because you know what? The moment you take it to your head that you're a manager, you have closed the doors for the learning which you were going to have. You know, you come with your preset notions. No, I've learned BCG model. Mereko the x-axis, y-axis pata, ispe yahan dabba banana, ispe yahan dabba banana, ispe star banana, ispe ye banana. Boss, but do you know how to apply the theory? Do you know how does it impact selling it? Do you know how does it actually work? But you know what? The guy who's a sales executive who runs in the field, apni moped leke jata hoga ya 10 logo ke paas jata hoga, he would know it better than you how to do that. He would know it better than you how to sell it. So you know what? That's what I would say. Learning, unlearning, absorbing. That's the point I'm saying. Learning is something which you would start by unlearning something. You're out from the college, forget you're out from the college. Believe me. You join as if you're a raw person who has come to learn something. That's what should be your aim for first 6 months. Or at least first 3 months, I would say. Forget whatever you have learned. Forget whatever you have thought about it. Just erase it, blank it. And that's what I would say, learning by unlearning mode. Try to see yourself at the junior most hierarchy of the organization. And you don't have to start behaving like that. I'm not saying that you start dressing like that and doing. It's only in the mind, I'm trying to say. Start absorbing everything. I mean, there's this fantastic book which I read. I don't recollect the name now. One of the quotes which it says is, our mind has to be like a sponge. The moment the sponge becomes inactive, we have lost the kill, what it says. I don't recollect the words exactly now. What it says is that if you are like a sponge and you keep absorbing the amount of water which is falling onto you, you would keep retaining it. The more you retain it, the more heavier you become. Yeah? More heavier you become, more is your output. The moment you squeeze, that is more is your output. So let your mind be like that. Keep it let coming. Let it all seep in. Let it just keep on going inside your head so that you use it at the right point of time it is required. Save it for then. Yeah, I mean that would be important. There's no point in spilling it all out when it is not required. So that would be erring. Yeah, rest is all, you know, very, very simplistic. Adaptation, which I believe is the biggest problem. You've learned all the theory. You've all learned statistics. Who's teaching statistics now? Okay, I don't know the gentleman. Somebody was teaching us, you know what, how he used to come to the classroom. Let's say, this is his, he used to carry a briefcase, yeah? And wo purana wala briefcase aata tha na, black wala, he would. So, he would come like this. So, OHP le hota tha unke paas, and he would start putting in slides. 1:2, not bothered, you're sleeping, not sleeping. Session khatam. Wahi hai. Okay, I don't want to open a can of worms. Your director here is smiling, so okay, let's relax. You know what? He was not wrong on what he was teaching. He was not wrong. His concepts, his everything was like perfect, perfect, as best it could be, textbook. Guys, just settle down. Otherwise, your whatever these people are called, the prefects or whatever, they'll all start acting. Chup ho jao, ye ho jao. So just settle down by yourself. It's easier for them and for me. I can wrap it up early so that you can catch 5 minutes of sleep then. You know, he was teaching everything perfect. But the problem was that we could never think through how it is to be used when it is to be done. Like, you know, everybody knows the law of averages, right? Everybody understands that. I mean, I'm sure everybody knows it. But when you're actually doing pricing, how do you do average pricing? What do you multiply by what? Believe me, I have a team of 38 people, out of which 25 people have been picked up by me, out of which 50% of the people didn't know how to do actual average price. Believe me. And I'm telling you, best of best people, with WorkX, without WorkX, when you tell them actually to do an average price, they don't know how to do it. Everybody knows the concept. I ask them concept, badhiya definition aajati, full-fledged. Means fantastic definition. But you tell them to do it, they don't know. So that's where the problem is, if you ask me. So, you know, and no one can help you. But believe me, you are in the good times where Dr. Google is available and you can foster your learning faster. You know, there's no problem you not knowing it. Just make an effort to find out how to apply it. That is what I would say, the second point. I mean, just because you've heard the term, don't think you know it. Try to adapt the theory into practice. The third topic is something which I personally preach, hands-on approach. Yeah, you sleeve, my sleeves rolled up, so that doesn't mean you roll up your sleeves. But when you have a task, it's been given to you. In the first few years of your career, try to go bottom-up, how the basics are done. And I'll try to give you an example. Let's say 10 of you were given the job of organizing an event. Let's pick any 10 people or 5 people, and you have someone with you who is a senior person. Oh, yeah, he will see the logistics. Don't go by that. If I were you, I would say, why don't you try to get your head in, how does the logistics works? How many cars are needed? How would the cars go? How would the cars come? How would you do the scheduling? I'm giving a very stupid example, but rather than giving you jargons, I'm just trying to explain you something very simple. Try to have a basic hands-on approach, so that in the initial period, whether it is related to you or not related to you, try to understand and learn it, because it will certainly help you. I'll give you this example. When I joined my first company, I was placed in Atul Limited from the campus. It used to be then, I don't know how it is, a very bureaucratic setup. You know what? I was just telling Dimple ma'am about this, and I'm sure you would all laugh. The office timings are 8 to 5, okay? Lunch time is 12 to 1. So people would all be there, and it's, and the average of that organization would be 40, 45. So when we all joined, that was the first year they had started taking management trainees. I think that was the first batch. Yeah. And in our college, since we can be placed in January also, so people from Nirma had joined in July, and we were there, like four of us, of which one of us got a homesick and he quit. But there were three of us who joined in January to them. I think January or end of January, I was placed around 10, 12th of January. And average age of that organization would have been 40, 45 years of the people who were working. And it was so funny, and we were shocked. So 12 o'clock, if lunch happens, people would open the tiffin boxes, eat in 10 minutes, 15 minutes. And after that, what I'm going to tell you, you'll be shell-shocked and laugh. I could see newspapers coming out of their drawers, from their bags. They would lay the newspapers on the table. Yeah, someone said sleep, right? And they would sleep for next 30, 40 minutes. And believe me, we three of us like, ye kya hai? And I can't tell you like what was the feeling. So you know, it was an organization like that. Even if a multi-million dollar order would come at, let's say, at 4:45, the guy would say, 15 minute pehle to main band karke ja raha hu, ab to wo kal login hoga. So you know what, in this process what happened is we started doing a lot of things by ourselves. There were 6-7 of us, and we really enjoyed what we did. So like I still remember I was responsible for domestic marketing. Somebody quit, I was given international. So I would take LC copies, physical copies, go to the bank myself, get it vetted, bring it back. You know, export post shipment, you know, export import documentation, you would have all learned, right? So wo invoice ki 5 copy banti aur BL ki 5 copy banti, right? Everybody knows that. Bullshit. 3 copy banti hai. In which way? I was just checking how many of you are asleep. Yeah, okay. No problem. No, I don't know how many copies are there, honestly, now. It's a wrong thing. So you know what, still I don't know, I okay, in those days there used to be 5 carbon papers which were put, and then you had to write on it till the last copy is legible. So you know, we would do that, and we all, the young team which was there, we enjoyed doing it because we could learn a lot of things which we had seen in this college, which we read through, but no other organization gives you an opportunity to go into it. So what we took that opportunity was, and we enjoyed, why? Because we could get into, let's say, post-shipment documentation, import documentation, seeing an actual LC, how does it come in, reading an LC, taking it to the bank. So we could see through the entire thing. And you know what, those 1.5 years, 2 years which I worked with that company, Atul, actually made me learn entire business process. Whatever I would have, let's say, learned in theory, I could apply it, see it actually happening over there. So that's what I would mean by hands-on approach. And yeah, the last point is more or less related to it. I've just tried simplifying it. Look on execution, look on, focus on task-based learning. If I'm doing this task, what do I learn out of it? Post-shipment documentation, if you're doing, did I actually learn it? So simple things, I would say. Many of you broke your legs, yeah? College has been hard on you, kicking on your feet, or what? Or fell apart because of the load, or because of looking somewhere else at the greener pastures. But I hope you guys are fine, right? But if you want to skip and go out, totally fine here, huh? Don't stress yourself. Yeah, so that's what I would call the second section about demystifying the word manager. And it would be a request from my side to all of you, yeah? I'll leave it on that. This is where the skills, so I don't think I'm a guru to define skills for you, yeah? I don't think that, but I've tried putting in some of the things which I actually personally believe in. And the first and foremost is very important. Humbleness, humility, whatever age, whatever position, whatever level you get onto, please try being humble. You know why Ratan Tata is respected? Why Narayan Murthy is respected? Why not Ambanis are respected to that matter? Believe me, I don't have anything against Ambanis, yeah? So I'm not trying to preach anyone. But my personal, let's say, idols would be JRD, Narayanan Murthy, Diaz, Ratan Tata, and you know what? My first cousin works in a Tata company, and he was telling me, we all have read it in newspapers saying that Tatas don't want to bribe any government official, right? We all have read that, correct? You know what he was actually telling me? He is with Tata Reality or some infrastructure project. He says they have very clear instructions. They don't pay 1 rupee.
They don't give even a gift. A sweet box is also not given to a government official. And you know, in the initial years, they had a lot of problems. But now what has happened because of that, when their proposal goes to a government employee, even they know it, if they don't clear it, they'll get weightage from top and they would eventually have to do it. So might as well do it in the first place. So you know, but in spite of that, if you meet a Tata employee and if you ever were to, I had the luxury and I would say the opportunity in my life to interact with Ratan Tata for 5-10 minutes. I was flying from some place. I was flying Vistara, and I think it was in the initial days. And he was going to board the airline as well. He was flying economy, by the way, yeah. Economy seat, and I had booked myself an economy, and it was a domestic flight. And I saw him in the lounge and I was talking to him. Believe me, had you not met him and seen his photographs, or rather, he was by himself, no one holding his bag. No one holding his bag. He had his bag by himself. He was over the counter in a lounge trying to take his food by himself and eat. No fuss. No fuss, believe me. Believe me, in fact, I was getting embarrassed by the welcome which I was getting. I was trying to tell, listen, hang on. I was feeling awkward today. And I do that always, but I'm just trying to tell you that that would be one of the most important qualities which you would have it. You would be one of the most loved people in an organization. You would be a people's person. Try being humble. I know at 24 years of age, 25 years of age, it is a difficult word to understand. I understand that. Believe me, somebody would have told me 10 years back, it didn't help. But when I reflect back, I think it is very important. I have been harsh. I have been aggressive in my initial days. I have been abrasive. I've done everything which could have been wrong. I've lost few team members because of that, but I've enjoyed good terms with them. And you know what? The feedbacks which I got, I tried working on that and I learned, if you have this, everything is repairable. But if you don't have this, you would mess up 50% of the situations just because of this. Would you like to work with someone who is aggressive to you? Huh? What have you done? Why have you not got your report? Please get your report. Would you want to work with that? The lady is very clear. You have to be. But would you want to work with someone? Listen, where's your report? You said, I've missed it, I'll get it. So he'll tell you, okay, this is the first time, but please get it tomorrow. You do it second time. He says, listen, I told you twice. Please get it correct. Would you not do it? Would you want to work with that gentleman? So that's where the difference is. Put yourself in someone else's shoes and see it. It's very simple. What you would not like yourself to be treated like, please don't do it ever to anyone. Believe me. I've learned it the hard way, but you don't have to do it. I mean, and you would see for yourself. That's what the second point is related to, people's person. I know I'm running out of time, so I'll start running because I took too much of time talking to Dimple ma'am and others. So I'll start shaving off some of the points. That's what is related to being a people's person. You don't have to be nice to everyone. You have to do the right thing. I came into the college, I didn't say anything. There are some points which I spoke to you, some of your directors and professors, which were not nice. I made some observations and comments which were very direct. But I'm sure they appreciate that. Those are points for learning and going better. So you don't have to be people's person by being nice. You have to be nice by being humble, by being direct, by being doing the right things, is what I would say. Third point is core to me. If someone were to say, I don't have passion doing it, please don't do it. Please don't do it. The reason why I'm here, you know, I've never made a speech like this before. So yeah, I don't know. Some of you can come and tell me, how was it? Bad, good, ugly? I could learn from it at least. But I believe that I've sat through this and I could come back and share something. So I had that passion to come and do it. That's why I came in. I spent 2 hours to put the points through. I've not prepared a PPT, but I felt I could do it. That's why I'm here. Maybe I'm right, maybe I'm wrong. Time will tell us. Maybe in the next 15 minutes I'll know it. Maybe tomorrow I'll know it. But you know, believe in what you're doing. Have that passion to do it. That's what is also related to define your successful career. Do you have passion, zeal to do it? Do you wish to do it? Then that would be the moment you arrive at it. The last point, very personal philosophy. Gentleman who said about Mercedes, good morning. There's nothing wrong in having Mercedes, yeah? There's don't worry. Yeah. there's nothing aspiring for it. There's nothing aspiring, but I would say my personal philosophy would be, don't run only after that. Don't look at the packages while placement, please. That would be a very humble suggestion from my side. Don't look at the number, look at the role and the job which is being offered. I went to Atul, my package was, I don't recollect now, but it was somewhere around 3 odd lakhs. Honestly, sorry, not even 3. With everything put together, CTC was 3. And you know what the surprise element, what happened when we reached the campus? I don't know if it is still now. They said out of 3 lakhs, they hold back some 70,000-80,000 which is given after 1 year. So you're getting a paltry salary of 10,000-15,000, 20,000, something of that sort. But you know what? I made a very right decision then to go with Atul. I didn't look at the money because the gentleman who had come from the company who made the presentation, he says, I don't promise you a training. I promise you a hands-on job which you would get and learning. And I wanted that. I could have gone to BSF. Dimple ma'am was upset because I did my summers and winters with BSF and I was absconding from BSF interview. Because when they could have given me a PPO, they never gave it. And they were going to come to campus later, so I took what was available. And I may not be right. You know what, guys, I cannot preach to you, I'm not a guru. But do what you believe is right, okay? But I would only suggest, don't look at money in the initial years. Do it right, you would get money. Believe me, that's something which I would tell you honestly. I can give it to you in writing that money would always come. You be at right place with the right organization, money would always come. Yeah, you know, 4 P's, 4 this, 4 that. I thought something jazzy, if I could coin it up, would make nice. I could try being a guru for that matter. So, yeah. So, I just tried putting something which I believe in. I use it and we use it in our office. We try to tell it to everyone. Energy is passion. So, I don't have to explain it. You need to have that energy, passion to do it. Second one is important. Can you energize someone? Can you pass on that energy to your team members? When you become a leader, when you grow, when you're working in a team, can you drive them all together? That is something which I actually believe in. If you don't have, you're not a team player, believe me. You need to have that in you. If you don't have it, build it. And that comes when you have the passion to make it happen. It would not happen without that. So please, energy, energize. 4 P's, jaise yaad kiye the, maybe remember it, don't remember it, whatever suits you, whichever way. But that is what I would say. Try to move the team together. You know, it could be a difficult task, but if the team is energized, you can make it happen. You can all make it happen. Edge. Yeah, so edge sounds very, very corny. What is the edge? I need to have the edge. What I believe by personally having an edge, please take risks. If you're not taking risks, give me 5 more minutes. I won't bother you after that. Yeah. If you have not taken risks in your career, you have played it too safe. If you have played it too safe, it means that you have not really tested your full potential. Yeah. Take risk. And you know what? Try to take risk where in some of the cases you would fail. There's no harm in it. And I'm sure the organization these days are much more open to it. We, at least in our organization, we build a culture. We are empowering our people to take risk. We allow them to take risk. Yash, Javed, the guys whom I spoke to you about, they will start taking decisions on pricing and other things in 3 months' time. In 9 months into the company, they would start taking decisions. Someone 10 years in the company, 11 years in the company, 5 years in the company is doing that. We want them to take that risk. We want them to do it. Because you know what? They would, and we know 50% of decisions will be wrong. Could be 70%. But if they don't do those mistakes, they would not learn. If they don't learn, they would always run it safe. I don't want that. We are trying to make leaders, we are trying to make, let's say, successful people, as the word success is called. I really don't that. But we really want to make people who are driven by passion. And you have that passion when you have taken those risks and you have succeeded. So test yourself. Do something. Take the case today. Maybe I'm going too much close to the edge. Not physically, but even actually virtually. I'm trying to come and talk to you. I don't know if it's successful. If it works, maybe I'll do it again. If it doesn't, yeah, I tested it. Something which I could do it better. So take risk is what I would say. And last point, you know what? We talk a lot. I would do this, I would do that. Please execute your verbal discussions. Build a plan, execute. You say, this is what I want to do it. Everybody asks, you would get several questions. 5 years down the line, what do you want to do? 2 years down the line. So please don't build plans, please execute. Execution would make the important thing. So those are the things. then these are points which I believe would be very important. The data available in coming times would be very complex, would be huge. One of the skills which you would need is good analytical skills to analyze the data. Regardless of the role which you're doing, you are in HR, you are in marketing, you are in finance, the amount of data which is going to be available would be phenomenally high. And you need analytical skills. I'll give you a simple example for the second point, POs. I didn't know how to make a PO till 2 years back. The new Excel really is very, very easy. But once I've started using it, it actually makes it very, very simple. So simple technologies, POs, other things would make it very easy. So learn technology, basics like Excel, I believe, is a fantastic tool. It could really do wonders if it is used properly. I know I'm rushing. I need to move out. I see the professors coming in again. So I can always talk later also. Learning curve. No organization is willing to invest 2 years, 3 years into an individual to learn. Nobody is willing to do it. You need to really pick it up fast and shorten the learning curve. Last, you would have heard it several times. You know, one short way to be noticed and be successful in an organization, I would say, would be the last point. If you can come up with an innovative solution which no one has thought through it, you would get all the attention which you can from every other person in the organization. But let it be of substance. Don't talk of an innovative solution. Haan, main isko tare dikha denge, usko jaise bolte hai na. Or tare dikha denge, let there be an actual plan tare dikhane ke liye. Yeah, so innovative solutions, creative ideas is a clear recipe for success, believe me. But have some substance backed by your idea for execution. One of the reasons why I've stuck around and I've done well in Doehler is this point. I believe in the ethos, the moral of the organization. Our vision statement, you can go and see on the website. We don't talk of jargons. It's very simple. Our global CEO believes in agility. That is being fast, nimble footed, passion, team play. And I believe in it personally. So the more you sing to the organization philosophy, the more you would be able to attach to it. I would only talk on this topic. Rest, I would leave it for you to understand and interpret, because you're all smart people. You know, there is an inherent problem with the way we approach these days problem. We discuss more of how and when. When will I do it? How will I do it? I need to go and do this. I need to do MBA. I will go to B school and do MBA. When will I do it? After my let's say graduation. Why? Has anyone questioned why? Why MBA? Why after graduation? Yeah? How many, please tell me honestly, how many of you did question why MBA? Why after graduation? How many of you questioned it? Could you just help me by raising your hands? Yeah, I see very, very few hands. Why? You know, that is a big flaw in the setup which we have. Big flaw in the setup and the way we think. Why? Because every other friend has done it. Why? Because my parents have told me. Why? Because my cousin has done it. Why? Because that's what the society talks about it. Why? Think over it. Why? Could you have done it 2 years later after working somewhere else, having little experience? Do you really want to do an MBA? No, I'm sure. No. Please don't get me wrong. I'm not trying to belittle anything over here. Yeah, I'm not trying to belittle anything over here. Would you want to do an MBA, or did you want to do an analytical course? Please question on the why is what I'm telling you. Why? The decisions which you make, actions which you do in your life, in your profession, and you know, believe me, there is nothing called as professional career, personal life. It's all mixed. It's a human brain. You can't make compartments in that. They almost made me feel great by doing an interview for this corporate citizen. So the gentleman who was doing the interview asked me, how do you balance your personal and professional life? I said, there is nothing called as that. We are a human being. You know, if you have a problem in personal life, you will carry it to office, and likewise too. There is nothing which compartmentalizes anything. So you know what, whatever you do in life, think of why first, then try answering how will I do it, and then when will I do it. Most of the decisions you will get it correct. The problem is we focus on the how and the when then. Sorry, I am also getting confused. The why needs to be answered. That is the most important thing. And we realized when we've been doing business, and you know, it struck to us when we made some of the wrong decisions. When some of the decisions went really, really wrong which I made and our team made, that is when we started realizing that we focused too much on how we want to do it. We never focused on when we want to do it and why we want to do it. Yeah. I'll skip the other points. You would have understood those. I would only talk about the last point because you understand other points. You know, you need to have fun. Believe me, wherever you go, whatever you do, if you can't have fun, you cannot succeed. Believe me. You know, we are a team which works. We're going through a tough time. Not in business terms, we're doing very well. But all of us are multitasking because our business has grown threefolds in a very short span of time. And we have not been able to build a successful middle management team because we were so fast in driving the business. That's what I said. I made a mistake on doing how, but I didn't focus on the why. We've actually done that mistake. I have done it. That's why I'm telling you. And I'm just sharing my mistakes. Believe me, I'm also correcting it. You know, my core team managers, they are still slogging out 12 hours. We are working some of the weekends. We are a multinational. But the reason why we are together, we still have a lot of fun. They can argue with me, come into my cabin and say, Shreyas, what the fuck, I mean, sorry. yeah, we give them liberty. You know, they have full right to question my decisions and likewise. We would tease each other out, we would test our brains, we would do everything which is there. But you know what? We would have hard discussions. They could really scream at me, I could scream at them. But we are having fun in what we are doing. We are building something up which we are extremely proud of. We are doing something, we are winning business, we are doing something which we are proud of. Guys, I would only request, have fun in what you do. If you don't have that, you're going to miss something extremely important. That is the most important thing of being successful. That's it.
The house. I know I've run out of time.
So we can have questions if you want.
Do we have time? I know the.
Yes, sir,
yeah, please. I'm okay with it. I can answer. Does anybody have any questions? Fully enlightened. Professor is saying fully enlightened. I thought fully bored to that. Nobody has a question. If you would allow, only if you would allow, and if you don't have any questions, there is one point I want to talk about. Thank you.
Sir,
that's the second last point on the previous slide.
Sir, upstairs.
Yeah, please. Sorry.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
My name is Preeti Oja. I'm in the junior batch, marketing finance, HRD.
Marketing finance and HRD.
HRD billing. BMI HRD building, sir. Sorry. My question is, if you are in a firm.
Can you just take it closer?
If you are in a firm that you wanted to work, and your work is going awesome for like 2.5 years, but still you don't see that your passion is growing or you're okay with it, how would you know that you're not at the right place?
Difficult question. I'll try to understand first of all what you're saying because...
If I can help, I'm from pharma background. I like, for example, I want to work with Hindustan Unilever.
Okay.
And God grace, I get it.
Okay.
I'm working with them. But still, if I'm good at, in case, in reality, I'm good at promotions or advertising. But I'm working good in my QC or analytical heading work in managerial section and Hindustan Unilever also. Still, the question is, how do I get that, yeah, this wasn't my part, promotion was my part.
Preeti, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Preeti, very good question, I would say, now that I've got it. It took a little while to understand, I'll be honest. You know, that's the difficult part, and you've nailed it. More often than not, you know, most of us, and I've seen several people, including my wife, to be honest. By the way, my wife is in HR and she's heading a firm, she's heading HR of that firm. But you know what? She's not good at it.
But honestly, she must not be.
No, she'll kill me for this. But before I finish and I let you off, what is she good at, if you ask me? Which she started doing it since last 1.5-2 years. She's a great designer. She's a great designer and she's great at creative things. You know, when I meant she's bad at HR, I mean she's loved by everyone in the office. She's doing a fantastic job. By the way, I mean she quit the organization when we moved from Gurgaon to Pune. They got her back. But if you ask me, her creative skills are far better. And that is what she really enjoys. Now, the difficult part which you actually asked, she couldn't get this also for a long while. I'll actually talk to you in experience because I don't think I can give you a gyan on how it is to be done. And I will try to help you to arrive at an answer. So what happened is she kept on doing it. She kept on grumbling of the HR thing. But she kept on painting and she designing. She was doing visiting cards. She was doing brochures. She was doing a lot of things here and there. Actually, it started with doing party invites just for the office, and it started by doing for friend, can you design this for me? And it kept on building. When she started doing it for a while, it struck her that she enjoys doing it more than a core thing. And then what happened is when she kept on talking to me, she gives me little importance with for my brain though, but several others around her, she realized that is what she wants to do. So to answer your question, I would say if you believe you're good at it, start dabbling at it. Start playing with it on a small scale first. Try to do it not in Unilever, but in your personal life. Try to do something, even in Unilever, if you happen to get selected, and you must, I would wish you all the best for that if that's your dream. In companies like Unilever, they allow you to engage into other teams. Raise up your hand, opt for it, say, can I be a part of it? Start contributing. Do it once, twice. Test yourself out. If you are satisfied and if you are able to rate yourself acceptable, go full hog. Don't go directly into it. I would only say that. If you are not sure of your passion, don't dive into it directly to ruin something which you have today. Yeah, I would say that. Take risk, but do calculated risk, I would say. It's very easy for me to say that, believe me. Yeah, but there is always a way which one figures out. And you know your situation, you know it best. I can't give you the right answers, but I can only guide you. That is the way I would do it if I were you in our place.
Because the threat in that is, if you're working in a firm for 2, 3, 4 years, and then leaving the total work and getting into a new thing from the base, it's a threat. Like we Indians
big
have
time.
Failures.
Big time.
Yes, sir.
Big time. And you know what? You need to be ready for that. That is where I said take risk.
Okay.
You have to be mentally prepared. Absolutely. You're bang on. There is a big risk. But to get better, you will have to cross on and take that leap of faith. And you know what, Preeti, I believe, if you deep down believe in your gut you can do it, you would excel. Don't think of the wrong part. I would try sending link to some of you here and which you can forward it. I wanted to put it, I couldn't get it last night in the flight. You know, we know Hrithik Roshan, right? Everybody knows in this room. Sorry? Yeah, there is a fabulous interview of his done by the lady who is Vidhu Vinod Chopra's wife, the film critic. You know it better. She's done a fabulous interview of his, which is available on YouTube. Yeah, and I would request you to go over it and have a look. I'll try pulling out the link, I would have it. And he talks about failures, negative criticism, and when he had to take up acting as a thing, he was trying to do something very similar which you're talking about. His father wanted to have a safety net and he wanted him to study, but he was not able to decide, should I go this way, and he was not able to make up my mind. I would not give you the final thing. I would want you to go the YouTube. I'm sure you guys are smart to figure out where it is. See what he says. And I personally believe, if you believe in your gut, you have it, you would do well. You'll have to take that leap of faith. Be ready for it, but what, both which ways, good or bad. That is what
Thank
I would
sir.
Advise.
Thank
Hope
you.
I could answer it.
As we are running short of time, this was the last question.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, we'll stop.
You want to tell something?
No, if there are questions, I would answer it. Otherwise, there is one point on authenticity which I had put in. I don't know how many of you read it. You know what I only realized in the GDPIs, which I took at several places, students tend to be not themselves. They tend to farce. They tend to fake themselves. Several of them. I would only request, don't do that. You would be great the way you are. If you tend to farce, you would only get this far, it would all ruin. The sham would break. Believe me, the guy sitting on the opposite side, he's done it enough. The guy or the lady would have seen it ample. The sham would break at some point or the other. So don't do that. That's the only point which I had, which I believe is very important. Yeah, that's it. Thank you very much for bearing with me.
Thank you, sir. We learned a lot from you, like the hands-on approach to learn, unlearn and absorb. Most importantly, to focus on the execution. Sir also highlighted the importance of 4 E's in shaping a successful corporate career. Thank you for
enlightening. Guy is really fast, huh?
Thank you for enlightening.
The 4 E's into speech.
Thank you for enlightening us with your words of wisdom. We look forward to many more such interactions on and off the campus.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Professor D.S. Kadam, Director, Project and Alumni Affairs, to present a memento to Mr. Shreyash Munot.
Battery check.